fate of Atlantis. When I got left off, we used a submarine to get here because Connor took Sophia away from us, and now he did it again. Now this is where pretty much all the paths merge into when you get here to Atlantis. It's just there's different ways to get here. And we're in the dark. So we have to touch things and figure out where
it feels like a steep rocky incline.
Probably use the ladder with the incline.
The ladder is in place.
This place is pretty dark. It could lighten up if we waited around long enough, but I noticed that it didn't show up on the video. So you're gonna have to rely on this.
It feels like a spindle for the stone discs.
Alright, so I found that. There's another stone thing here.
It feels like a stone box.
Okay, then we gotta open that.
It's open.
Alright. I can touch the...
It's a metal rod with an opening on one end.
Alright. Want that. And we have orichalcum in the box, so use the orichalcum in here. Atlantis.
Sophia, where are you? Kerner must have grabbed her somehow.
Well, I don't blame him because we actually took them with us on the submarine. But I call shenanigans that they got in here while I had the stone disc. Because we can't just push this door.
I'll never open this door manually. I can't move it.
Yep. Alright. We also see that the submarine is parked out here.
Stone disc with lunar images carved into it.
Yes, just the stone dome. And we're gonna set the combination, so... Unless you, looked up a there's no way you would know what this means. You would set the combination, you try this.
That didn't seem to do anything.
And it didn't do anything. What do you do? You have to set this 180 degrees from what the combo was. So it should look like this for us.
The mouth of the statue opened.
And what do? We use orichalcum in the mouth. And that'll open the door. Probably want to take the stones with us. Because we never know if we're going to use them anywhere else. They are the keys. And we're going to go in. Now you're going to look at this and be like, oh god, it's a maze, am I going to get lost in here? The answer is probably yes. But this maze, doesn't seem too hard. Because your goal is to get to the center. Now, but you're also going to want a couple things. There's a lot of rooms here. And the rooms are slightly randomized. It depends which room it is. I'm going to walk around the perimeter a little bit because there's something in particular I want to pick up that I know is on the perimeter. The perimeter room does not change. Like, change what you see in here, what you have to do. So a lot of this is going to be me fumbling around trying to figure out which room is what in this scenario, and then doing what we can the perimeter is like a subway of sorts.
It's a cage of ribs, more or less intact.
Someone died on the subway. That's awful.
Now, this might be useful.
A rib cage. Why do you want to do that right now? It is important for later, but I just don't like walking around the perimeter too much because it takes so long to walk. There are also guards here. You could run into them and fight them. And I think in one of the paths, you do have to fight at least one in each corner. So let's go into this room and see what we can do in here. Also, these guys don't come into the rooms at all.
Dr. Jones, now we've got you.
Another Nazi stooge.
These two will let you fight, and then this one won't let you fight. I'm gonna not fight for the sake of doing this path.
Maybe I better head west.
Come back and fight like a man!
I'll just go to this room. In the team path, in any paths you could fight, but I'm gonna show off how to fight in the fist path if I can. Depends how the other paths go. Alright, so in any of these rooms where these grates are here, you probably want to open it and go in and see where it leads, because there are certain rooms, like this room for instance. This room, you find an eel sculpture, you're gonna want to get. It's like the same eel sculpture that you found in the beginning of the game and that you gave to Costa. Like this room, you won't be able to find this room on the map, but you can find it only through grates, so you want to make sure you open the grates. There's also other reasons why you would want to open the grates. Okay. He's back. This room doesn't change too much, it gets randomized, but you want to use the ladder, this cup, and come back here, and always take the ladder with you because it's always useful for scenarios like this where you want to walk across the walls. And sometimes you notice the statues are big as well. Statues are harder to climb unless you have a ladder. Yes, this room is randomized. It can appear in a different area of the map.
It must have been part of some ancient machine.
There's a lot of.
You'd think the Atlanteans wouldn't be such slobs.
There's a lot of robotic stuff in here. Let's see where this crate goes. Found that. Okay, so that's the room we came out of. So this room. We can't do anything with this room quite yet, but we will want to remember it's here, and it will specify what this room is. But it's cool that there's lava.
It looks very, very hot.
You can't jump in the lava, which is probably a good thing. Lava hurts a lot. Another grate. Sometimes these grates like warp you around, so it can be very confusing to navigate this area. Oh. We found the dungeon. The dungeon doesn't change where it is on the map. The statue.
It's another one of those stone robots.
I'm surprised he's able to see it through this particular vent. So
she's
strange.
Trapped. I can't reach it.
She can't reach it.
I can't reach it.
Another
It's an empty bowl. It's carved in a bizarre pattern. Funnels are what you pour liquids into.
Usually.
It's carved to look like a beetle.
They admire beetle, I guess. So, this room we'll have to come back to later because we don't have enough things for this room. But it is noted. I've seen this room be this room, so that's why I say it's slightly randomized. There's nothing here. Okay. Let's go to this room next. It's the one with the pot. That's where he came from.
This must be Crab Central.
Alright, so usually when you catch like crabs or lobsters, you put them in these cages that look like a wooden, it has like a wooden box outside, but it has like a bunch of wiring like chicken coops or whatever, but we don't have that. The closest thing that we have is this rib cage here. So we can use the rib cage.
Worked.
In here. And you know what? We also been carrying this gum. Maybe they like gum. I like planting.
Now there's more bait in there.
There's not a reason why you would want to put so much food in there, but I like doing that just because it's funny that the crabs can eat pretty much anything here. Which makes sense because like the crabs are.
I hope this catches crabs.
Wow, he instantly got a crab.
Feisty crab in there.
He's probably mad that we caught him. We need him for reasons later. I just don't like backtracking this place because it takes so long to walk. Alright, there's nothing in here. You would think catching a crab in the random rooms like that would do something, but no, that's not the case.
Dr. Jones, now we've got you.
We'll see about that.
Oops, wrong turn.
Come back and fight like a man.
No, I'm not fighting you. He's stunned for a bit, so we were able to get away. Okay, now we've done all these rooms. Come on, game. That's what happens when you click out of the window fast sometimes, and it just doesn't move. So we've explored all of those. So we're in this room. So we can't get in here because of the
Dr. Jones, you got away before, but not this time.
Don't be too sure. I think I should backtrack here.
Come back and fight like a man.
No, I don't want to fight you. He's done. Go through, go through. All right, this will work. Right. Okay. So we found this statue. Okay.
It looks like a stone fish head.
Interesting.
Looks like a cross between a bull and a fish.
Well, it makes sense that they appreciate the fist now that they're under the sea. Let's see what this room is. Another grate. Hopefully that grate leads into the two rooms that I showed you.
Must have been part of some ancient machine. What a mess.
Apparently, the machine parts here are... I've been picking up the machine's parts so far. They are interchangeable to machines for some reason, so... That's good. At least the hardware store here is probably, like, the best stop for anything.
It's got a wide open mouth.
I could probably put orichalcum in there when we ran out, but it's okay if we ran out before.
It seems to be blocking the doors.
Yeah, we don't want, more water leaking in. That's not good if there's already leaking. This room we won't be able to get to until we unlock this room. That's the room where we saw Sophia, by the way. Where is... Yes, okay, so now I have enough stuff to go to. Because we have that fish head, which has a big old mouth. Sometimes the guards will walk in those rooms. Oh, he almost, ran into him. I'm surprised he doesn't chase me. These guards don't chase you, but you would think they should. That and we have more lava flow. And this is the only thing that can hold lava because it's made of stone.
I'd rather not stick my hand under a stream of molten lava.
We did this in the wrong
way. It doesn't seem to open.
Don't open it, pick it up. Somehow we did that with our bare hands. Okay, so we want to use the cup here first. And then use the head.
Aha!
Espresso or something. Ran into
Dr. Jones, is it? Now we've got you.
We'll see about that.
Alright, I
maybe I better head east.
Come back and fight like a man.
No, I don't want to do that. Like, he could follow me, but he's gonna chase me down. Crazy man. Alright, so this machine room. Bunch of parts, but we want to. You notice that the machine.
It's a bronze wheel.
It's missing a thing here.
Looks like something's missing.
And it's said it was a bronze wheel, so we should put the wheel with the wheel.
That looks much better.
The wheel symmetry. And we can pour liquids up in this bottle, so I only take this lava and put it up there. I guess we caused some inflation now with those beads, because now you can just make them out of lava. It's weird that they give off a uranium-like...
Well, well, orichalcum beads.
Just from lava.
I'll put them in the box, too.
I don't know how you would do that. And is there, like, properties of lava that we have researched about that do give off energy or something? So now we have things to do in the Sentry Hall. Why are you going this way? Go. What? Fine. Just leave me. Let him go water in that room.
Indiana Jones. Looks like your adventure is over.
Another Nazi stooge. Maybe I'd better head north.
Give up, Jones. There's no escape.
Maybe I quickly get into this room before he, does things. Okay. So now that we're here, we can use orichalcum. We pretty much have unlimited orichalcum.
Uh-oh, that didn't work very well.
That's probably because there's a lot of water in there. Huh. I never made that thing's head fall off before. That's because I usually... oh yeah. Remember in the game that this thing, like, heated up and melted itself out of the ice? I could probably use that same heat in this thing.
Hey, it's getting hot.
To... evaporate the water. Now, I don't know how it evaporates all of the water, but it apparently does.
It's all that's left of the eel statue. I don't need a worthless heap of slag.
This door can still open because, good. The other guy opened it. Good enough for me. I never make that thing so my head fall off. That was interesting. Alright, so we could go in here and see if we could rescue Sophia. Especially now that this guy's dead. He would fight you if you didn't do the statue thing. I picked up a part because...
Once it was a priceless artifact. Now it's a pile of junk.
It could still be... Some of it could still be priceless because we picked up this
thing. Some kind of machine part.
A lot of the machine parts are universal. Anything on this guard?
Not much left of him.
Nope. Alright. We could probably talk to her.
Sophia?
To get her out.
What?
I just crawled through a mile of mud for you.
It was a picnic compared to life in this cell.
You haven't spent much time here in this cell. You probably spent, like, 20 minutes here.
Are you all right?
I'll feel a lot better once you open this cell.
She's pretty mad.
Did you miss me?
Put it this way, even your company beats this cell.
I mean, I would be mad, too, if I turned and, like,
sure this is safe?
Sure, let's go, Sophia.
I don't know. The door makes me nervous.
Brace the door with a rock.
I don't have a rock.
I'm surprised we didn't drop it on her foot. So she won't go through unless she's able to brace the door or something. She doesn't trust us. Even though we were able to hold that up for quite a while. We're probably going to want to hand something too, and I can also fit through these bars, because if we try to use the ladder, obviously that will
work. I don't think that'll work. I don't think that'll work.
Oh. Maybe try again.
I don't think that'll help me.
Yeah. We don't have much else here that we can give her that's, like, been bracing.
It'll never fit between the bars.
It would work, but it'll never fit between the bars. Unfortunately, we're gonna have to leave you here. I do apologize about leaving you here. There is a bad ending to this game that will show up later, too. That
Jones! Don't you dare leave me here, you troglodyte!
But, I'm gonna show off the good ending for right now, only because that seems much more fun. I guess in the next episode, we'll deal with whatever this is.